Back on Oahu, the Barbers Point Flight School is seeing an increase of students with an ongoing worker shortage in the airline industry.
Dallas Ontiveros joins us live from Kapolei with all the details. Morning, Dallas.
Good morning, Christian Ross. And here to tell us more about on what's happening here at Barbers Point Flight School, we have a special guest. This is our friend Kylie. She's an administrative assistant and flight school student. Good morning, Kylie. How's it going?
Good morning. It's going well. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having us here. This is such a cool space. It's our first time here.
Yeah, so as a student at Barbers Point Flight School, this is what you would expect to come into. So our students right now are currently studying with their CFI, just going over some nav logs, basic ground information. So this is the normal scene that you would come into as a student. Just come in, meet with your CFI, and then grab your binder for your aircraft and head out.
A lot of information, and what a comfortable space to study too. I like this.
Oh, yeah.
And for you, Kylie, we've been talking about a worker shortage in this aviation industry. Mm-hmm. What made you want to be a part of this school and just jump into the industry this way?
Yeah, so I initially started my aviation career in Utah, but once I graduated, I moved back home and hit the ground running again with my flight training down here. So I think aviation has always been something I've been wanting to do, and I've had the fortunate opportunity to come home and seamlessly continue my my training at Barbers Point Flight School. So our owner and CEO, Reginald Perry, built this school starting in 2010, and since then we've dramatically have grown. As of right now, we do have a wait list of students who are actively wanting to, you know, start their flight training specifically with us. So I've definitely seen a dramatic like increase, especially due to the pilot shortage. It's a good opportunity to start aviation now with job security and everything that's going on.
And well said. You know, we're definitely in that great resignation. People are looking for new careers, but they probably have questions on affordability, because I know there are a lot of different programs and certifications with Barbers Point Flight School.
Yeah, so as a student, you would start off with your private certificate. You need a minimum of 40 hours for that. National average is around 60 to 80. From your private certificate, you would move into your instrument rating. So instrument is solely referencing the instruments in your aircraft in the cockpit. Once you get your instrument rating done, you'll move on to your commercial rate certificate. That certificate allows you to get paid as a pilot. At that point, you can then decide if you want to become a CFI, so a flight instructor, so continue your training there, or receiving your multi-engine, which we do all of those ratings here, or building your hours elsewhere. So that's pretty much everything that we offer at our school.
And last question right here, because you're sharing a lot of great information with us, what is the end goal and dream goal for you?
Yeah, for me, I'd love to go to the airlines. Obviously, Hawaiian has their hub here, so staying in Hawaii, being near family, is a big dream of mine. But of course, anywhere that will take me traveling, that's what I love about aviation, is that you're not really in one place for a long time. You get to travel and see the world. So my end goal would be the airlines.
All right, the possibilities are endless. Thank you so much, Kylie, for sharing.
Thank you so much.
And we'll be out here throughout the show to give you more details on what Barbers Point Flight School has to offer, and also what the climate looks like with the aviation industry. But for more details and other related stories, you can visit our website at kh12.com. Reporting over here in Kapolei, Dallas Ontiveros, KH12 News, working for Hawaii.
Dallas, thank you. 6:09 right now. Coming up next, we're working for Hawaii with a live look at the roads and those drive times.